In 1979, cinema audiences around the world discovered that in space, no one can hear you scream. Ridley Scott's Alien, starring a then-unknown Sigourney Weaver, portrayed a vision of the future much darker than Star Wars did only 2 years previously. It told the story of a small group of space truckers who unknowingly pick up an alien life form aboard their spacecraft. The alien picks off the crew one by one, with only Weaver's Ellen Ripley barely surviving. It was a massive critical and commercial hit, but a sequel would not arrive until 7 years later. In 1984, writer and director James Cameron released his first film, The Terminator. It was a smash hit, making a huge star out of its lead, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Cameron then turned to a project he had been developing, a sequel to Alien. But while the original film was a haunted house movie in space, Cameron's movie would be a war movie, with an army of aliens out to destroy a small group of Marines on a colony planet. Ripley would quickly take charge and face the nightmare again. The movie opens with Ripley's shuttle adrift in space. She is soon picked up by a passing ship, and on returning to Earth, finds that she has spent the last 57 years in suspended animation. During a debriefing of the events on the Nostromo, it becomes clear that no one believes her story of how the alien killed her crew, and she is suspended. Later, while making a living as a loading dock worker, she is told that a colony that has been set up on the planet the Nostromo visited has stopped communicating. Ripley reluctantly agrees to accompany a squad of Marines to the colony, not knowing that the horror she is about to revisit has become worse than she could have possibly ever imagined. Aliens, in my opinion, remains a classic 34 years on from its original release. It's not only a great follow-up from the original film, it's such an entirely different film that it stands alone and does not require any previous knowledge of Alien. It has a great cast, fantastic visual and practical effects, and a career-best performance from Sigourney Weaver. It's easy to take for granted now, but in 1986, to see such a strong leading character be played by a woman in a major Hollywood blockbuster was extremely rare, and Ellen Ripley remains one of the best heroines in the history of cinema. The genius of the film is that it multiplies the threat of the original movie, that has a seemingly superior force of well-armed Marines get slaughtered by an enemy that appears primitive at first, but overwhelms the soldiers with sheer numbers. In fact, many have commented that the film can be seen as an allegory for the war in Vietnam. The comparisons are obvious. For all the horror, however, it's easy to forget how funny the movie actually is. The late Bill Paxton's Private Hudson provided a great deal of comic relief, as he goes from an overconfident macho man to squealing like a coward, while his fellow Marines find him annoying. For the audience, his panicked outbursts are hilarious. What's amazing to me is how well the film is dated. In a filmmaking age long before CGI did all the hard work for filmmakers, the practical effects, stunts, and model work remain some of the best ever put on film. Stan Winston, Cameron's regular creature effects supervisor, builds on H.R. Giger's original design. The highlight, of course, being the monstrous Alien Queen. On its original release, Cameron was encouraged to release a cut of the film nearly 20 minutes shorter than he would have liked. His director's cut ended up being released some 6 years later, and in my honest opinion, this is an inferior version. While it adds some backstory to Ripley's personal life, we discovered that she had a daughter who passed away while she was in hypersleep, and some additional footage of the alien colony, the theatrical cut remains a leaner, tighter film. So Aliens, in my opinion, is an all-time classic. It's not only a great film in its own right, it's one of the best examples of sequel making. It's frightening, action-packed, funny in all the right places, and has one of the best action heroines in the history of cinema. In fact, the only downside is that the film was too good, as none of the subsequent films in the series came anywhere near to surpassing it. Maybe it's best to pretend that the series ended here, with Ripley having faced her greatest fear, finally achieving closure.